I'd like to start out with a new song and sort of have the band dribble on. As a matter of fact, probably the cello is one of the more unique aspects of the group. And Mr. Kim Scholes, if he would come on out here and help me with this, it'd be sort of nice. And talking about family and my mother, my brother Steve has produced the last three albums we've done, and indeed the album, I guess, that came out last week here. And he's sort of been the quality coefficient in the music in this group for about the last almost 3 years now. And if Steve, you come out and help me out on this first song, my brother Steve Chapin. Sort of got a nice feel to this house, too. I have a feeling there have been some good concerts here, and hopefully we can do something for you. I'd like to ask you a question, we can immediately make this place into a living room. You know, the sexual revolution has had some interesting ramifications. The first is that all of a sudden, everybody has a history. In the past, you know, a lot of us were saving it for marriage or something, and by the way, do you know what it is? Some people are a little confused. But I'd like to just do a quick poll, because since everybody has a history, the question is, when you have a new relationship, do you tell your new mate about the old ones? Okay? How many people believe that you should be completely frank and tell your new partner about all the past experiences? Now, how many believe that you should be completely mum and not say one word about your past? The rest of you don't know what it is, I guess. Well, anyway, I guess the mums have it. Well, this is a song from the point of view of myself having a relationship with a gal that has obviously had a past, and I'm damn insecure because she hasn't said a word. I'm the green young gentleman, and you're the lady with the past. And I guess I'm insecure about how long this will last. And so I sort through in my mind the little that I know, and the only things I find from where my musings go is that kind of confusion that just makes more questions come about the wild and shady world that you must have wandered from. You see, I have no real complaints of how you've left your past behind. I guess what gets me worried is you've erased him from your mind. And I wonder what happened to him. Your past is a canyon, and I'm a stranger on the rim, looking down below to where it's misty and dim. But where there's still shining a faint glow from a light, it makes me wonder where he is tonight. There's that drawer of your old photographs that sits there like detectives' leads, with that packet full of letters that I do not dare to read. And then there is that negligee that is made for candlelight. You know, I've never seen you wear it. Was it used on other nights? You see, dream lover of a lady, what shakes me to the core is the thought, as you caress me,
that you've done this all before. And I think about our future with me out and others in. Will I too have disappeared like I've never ever been? And I wonder what happened to him. Your past is a canyon. I'm a stranger on the rim, looking down below to where it's misty and dim. But where there's still shining a faint glow from a light, it makes me wonder where he is. I wonder where he is. Can't help but wonder where he is
tonight. We have the paparazzi with us tonight. Make sure that you click at all the silent spots, okay? But in rhythm, please, okay? Now, it's sort of interesting. I've had many years when people have taken photographs of me, and I look about 45 every time. How many people, before they ever saw me in live, thought I was about 45 years old? You know, beat to hell, you know, somebody who's... A lot of my music, I guess, is from a...
I did.
By the way, oh, we got some more people joining us. Dougie Walker on lead guitar, if you remember.
Thank you. How are you doing there?
Howie Fields, incredible percussionist, drums. And founding member of this group back on June 22nd, 1971, with myself.
And, has it been that long?
Oh, God, John, it has. Big John is 34 years old tonight. Big John Wallace.
To you, happy birthday.
Key of G. One, a two. Sing happy birthday for him. What the hell?
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
Like to do a song about the two oldest professions in the world. You figured out one of them. Okay. The question is, what is the second? Okay.
Computer programming. No. I'm sorry.
Close, John.
I lost.
Is this going to be one of your rowdy nights?
No.
He occasionally uses chemical additives, which, you know, puts a kind of distorted perspective on everything, but... Supply him later, okay? A 1, 2, 3, 2, 2, 3, 3, 2, 3, 4. It's a slow motion night in the hot city lights. Past time when the good folks are snoring in bed on a loose jointed cruise to recolor your blues and with illegal notions alive in your head. And you're back from some war that you've been fighting for, some old blue blood bastard in a dark pinstripe suit. And the word from your loins has your mind in your groin and your back pocket burning with blood, with blood money loot. And you walk past the glow of
the Flickr picture shows, where the raincoat men wait for a child to come by, and the women in doorways who have nothing to say, 'cause your money is talking to the ones that you would try. And she owns the block with a dent pawn shop clock. She's the answer to dreams that you pay to come true. She's got no heart of gold, but that's not what she sold. She just sees herself doing what she has to do. And she's all that you're hoping as her coat falls open. Give her bread and she leads you to a bed on the floor, where for 10 million years and through 10 billion tears, the armies of bootmen have marched back from their walls. She's in that state of grace before time finds a face, with a mind of old wisdom and a body still young. And she tastes as sweet as a child's chocolate treat before the butts and the whiskey have wasted the taste of your tongue. Oh, play the music again of the gray stubble men. That groaning blue symphony moans evermore. Then you watch as she fakes it, and of course you just take it. She's better than others you never paid your money for. And you've used up your booty, and the girl's done her duty, and the turnstile is turned, and you learn you are done. And you're back on your street, joining fresh marching feet. You see more soldiers coming, and your girl chooses one. And the medic has bought shots for what you have caught, and your leave is all over, you're back on the line. And you joke in the trenches of the hot-blooded wenches, and the things that you'll do when they next give you the time. And you're back in your army, back shedding red blood, and you dream of the girl as you sleep in the mud. And you know you'd swap with her if the deal could be made, 'cause you'd rather be working at love, as love as your trade.
Anybody up there in the cheap seats? Does it sound okay up there? Okay, good. I, as usual, have a special interest in there, because I always used to sit up there, and you can
You can get away with a lot more up there, and it's got a lot of advantages. One more new song, if I may, sort of in the same, you know, subject matter. A friend of mine and her husband were listening to some of my songs about a week ago. I mean, not a week ago, a year ago. And these are people that, even when I was a filmmaker between 1965 and 1971, still were interested in my music. I don't know why. I wasn't doing music full-time, but I was just doing it around the edges. But they were always an audience for me. And they said, you know, Harry, you've written an awful lot of songs about sexual liberation of one sort or another, but you've really never written a song from the female point of view. And I admitted a certain weakness in terms of female experiences, but I said, you know, there are some experiences in my life where perhaps, you know, where the double standard reared up and smacked me right in the face. And I thought maybe I could try a song about that. And so I was playing games, and then all of a sudden I came up with this song. And we've sung it about 6 or 7 times, and we found out that women like this song about 367% more than men do. So we'll see if the percentage holds true tonight. Okay, just listen to the lyrics, and it's a true story about a couple years back. Let's see. One, two, three, four. She wore an SEGS. She came back home like the cat that ate the canary. And I stood befuddled, a chauvinist stud, with his mistress quite contrary. I was smack up against the moment I was afraid I would face someday. But the truth is a wall that you can't blow down, and it won't be laughed away. You see, my old lady took herself a young man last night. You got me crazy when she said, baby, don't you get uptight. She said, well, maybe it's the time for you to see the light. She said, it's all right now, boy, I'm yours tonight. Imagination's been the sweetest sinner of all. Yes, it lives like a snake in Eden, and it forgives each time I fall. You know, I've been Casanova, I double dated with Don Juan. And while I've been doing almost everything, I never dreamed she'd be carrying on. You see, my old lady took herself a young man last night. You got me crazy when she said, baby, don't you get uptight. She said, my baby, it's the time for you to see the light. She said, it's all right now, boy, I'm yours tonight. This first, she says that she still loves me. She says the last night was no big deal. She says, why can't a woman play the same damn game and act out what she feels? She says she's gonna take a bath. I hear her singing in the tub upstairs while I'm sitting there spitting out chunks of my heart, forced into being fair. While she's splashing around up there, I suppose to act like I don't care. I hear the devil laughing somewhere. You see, my old lady took herself a young man last night. I got me crazy when she said, baby, don't you get uptight. She said, my baby, it's the time for you to see the light. She said, it's all right now, boy, I'm yours tonight. This next song still gives me shivers, and it's not because I wrote it. It's because of Big John's performance in the role of Mr. Tenor. Mr. Tenor was a cleaner from a town in the Midwest. And of all the cleaning shops around, he'd made his the best. But he also was a baritone who sang while hanging clothes. He practiced scales while pressing tails and sang at local shows. His friends and neighbors praised the voice that poured out from his throat. They said that he should use his gift instead of cleaning coats. Music was his life, it was not his livelihood, and it made him feel so happy, and it made him feel so good, and he sang from his heart, and he sang from his soul. He did not know how well he sang, it just made him whole. His friends kept working on him to try music out full time. A big debut and rave reviews, a great career to climb. Finally they got to him, he would take the fling. A concert agent in New York agreed to have him sing. And there were plane tickets, phone calls, money spent to rent the hall. It took most of his savings, but he'd gladly used them all.
Oh, Floor,
music was his life, it was not his livelihood, and it made him feel so happy, and it made him feel so good, and he sang from his heart. And he sang from his soul. He did not know how well he sang. It just made him whole. The evening came, he took the stage, his face set in a smile. And in the half-filled hall, the critics sat watching on the aisle. But his concert was a blur to him, spattered of applause. He did not know how well he sang, he only heard the flaws. But the critics were concise, it only took four lines, and no one could accuse them of being overkind. Mr. Martin Tenor, baritone of Dayton, Ohio, made his town hall debut last night. He came well prepared, but unfortunately his presentation was not up to contemporary professional standards. His voice lacks the range of tonal color necessary to make it consistently interesting. Full-time consideration of another endeavor might be in order. He came home to Dayton and was questioned by his friends, but he smiled and just said nothing, and he never sang again. Excepting very late at night when the shop was dark and closed. He sang softly to himself as he sorted through the clothes. Music was his life, not his livelihood. It made him feel so happy, and it made him feel so good, and he sang from his
sang from his soul, and he did not know how well he sang. It just made him me. What did you think when you heard me back on the radio? What did the kids say when they knew it was their long lost daddy? Oh, remember how we listened to the radio and I said that's the place to be, and I got the job as an FM jock the day you married me. It was two kids and I was in the air, but I just had to run around. It's been 8 years since I left you, babe. Let me tell you about what's gone down. I am the morning DJ at WOLN. Playing all the hits for you, wherever you may be. Who's heard but never seen? Oh, feeling all of 45, going on 15. The drinking I did on my last big gig made my voice go low. They said that they liked the young sounds. Let me go. So I drifted on down to Tulsa, Oklahoma, to do the late night talk show. Now I work my way down home again in a Boise, Idaho. That's how this business goes. I am the morning DJ at WOL. Okay, Steve, you got it again, man. Do me the bridge. London Bridge, Tower Bridge, take your pick. I've been making extra money doing high school socks. I'm a big time guest MC. You should hear me talking to the little children and listen what they say to me. But it's never gonna go away.
All right. Getting it into it tonight.
Sometimes I get this crazy dream that I just take off in my car. But you can travel on 10,000 miles, still stay where you are. I've been thinking that I should stop this joking and start that record store. Maybe I could settle down if you take me back once more. Okay, honey, I see. I guess he's better than me. Sure, old girl, I understand. You don't have to worry, I'm such a happy man. Let's Thank you.
All right, good. Woo. John, down a little. Can I have a little guitar in the monitor?
You know, that's about a guy 45 going on 15. There's a lot of interesting reactions to growing older. Some people try to hold back the age barrier. In Hollywood especially, we'll see, you know, great grandmothers going around in hot pants and a convertible, you know, trying to convince themselves that their latest facelift and also salutary effects on their body, you know. This is a song about a guy who's probably about 45. It comes from riding on commuter railroads. And there were two mornings this past week. One morning where I came down from Chester on a train, and one morning I came down from, God, where was that other? I know, up near Stratford. What's the town near Stratford?
Warwick.
Yeah, I guess it was that. Is there a town called Warwick? There's Warwick Castle.
Warwick,
okay. Well, anyway. We've been, you know, touring around, you know, all that jazz. But, and you see the same thing, you know, people in suits, you know, ta-ta, you know, just perfect. And I'm sure stalwart men of the realm, you know, very upright gentlemen. And then a girl, attractively attired, maybe 20 years younger than they, walks down the aisle. And you watch what happens in their eyes. That's what this song is about.
A one, a two, a one, two, three, four.
There's no tick tock on your electric clock, but still your life runs down. Tick-tock on your electric clock, but still your life runs down.
I'm halfway to heaven, and my home in Forest Hills. It's 11:30. I've got some time to kill. I missed my bus connection because the train got in too late. And now I'm forced into reflection by this half-hour wait. You see, I have been a straight man, and I played it by the rules. I've been a good man, a good husband, a good old-fashioned fool. I have a fine wife and two children, just like everybody's got. But after 15 years of marriage, the fires don't burn too hot. Set me up so perfectly. They gave me their morality and then changed the rules they set for me. Someone must be laughing now. Lord, don't seem funny somehow. How the world's accepting now what they once would not allow. Back in my younger days, the world has changed in so many ways. My mother once said to me, so many years ago now, don't you touch those bad girls. So I never had girls until I had my marriage. When we married, my marriage then had my two sons. My life as a lover was already done. It was over before it had really begun. Someone played a trick on me. They sent this little girl to me. She is my new
secretary, and she's something to see. Yeah, she's a nice girl, but it's a young world, and she lives her life so free, and she sure gets through to me. Something deep inside of me, yeah, something starts to hurt. You know she's wearing nothing underneath, and I can see what there's to see. And she smiles and says, you wanted me, and I'd have to agree. You know how much I want her, and I know that I could have her. Yes, I know I could, I know she would make love to me so wonderfully. God damn, I'm one crazy mixture of a man. And in my head all my life I've been a sinner. And in my bed with just my wife, I'm still a beginner. But tomorrow night, I'm taking that little girl out to dinner.
Just not to give you the wrong impression about myself and marriage, I've married about almost 9 years now, and this is a song about how I met my wife in the first place. Oh. Excuse me. Little Chinese tuning there for a moment. Close enough.
I come fresh from the street, fast on my feet, kind of lean and lazy, not much meat on my bones, and a whole lot alone, more than a little bit crazy. And the old six string was all I had to keep my belly still. And for each full hour lesson I gave, I got a crisp $10 bill. You see, she was married for 7 years to a concrete castle king. She said she wanted to learn to play the guitar and to hear her children sing. So I'd show up about once a week in my faded tight leg jeans, with a backlog full of hobo stories and a dilapidated dream. She said, I want to learn a love song full of happy things. She said, I want to learn a love love song. Won't you let me hear you sing? She said, I wanna learn a love song. Wanna hear you play. She said, I wanna learn a love song before you go away. Tried to teach her a couple of chords and an easy melody, but it always turned out she'd rather listen to my guitar and me. I could hear an old man laughing in the den, playing stud poker with the boys, while I sang so soft in the living room, too scared to make much noise. I came one week and the den was dark, and she met me at the door, and we sat on the couch and we sang and talked till I could not sing no more. You know the silence kept on building, and her eyes grew much too wide, and I could hear both of our heartbeats, but there was no place to hide. She said, I want to learn a love song full of happy things. She said, I want to learn a love song. Won't you let me hear you sing? She said, I want to learn a love song. Want to hear you play. She said, I want to learn a love song before you go away. You know what happened? My God, I've never been so clean. Yeah, I feel like I'm working in a Hollywood movie or living out a good, bad dream. And all them pin-up girls in that tinsel world never touched me like she can. It took another man's wife in the real world life to make this boy a man. She said, I want to learn a love song. She said, I want to learn a love song. Won't you let me hear you sing? She said, I want to learn a love song. Want to hear you play. She said, I want to learn a love song before you go away. I guess you know I stayed. Thank you. Another song about family is one my wife and I wrote about my daughter. I guess the most impressive thing I've done in my life is somebody coming? God almighty.
It's roaches.
Yeah. The most impressive thing I've done in my life, as I said, I've been married to about 9 years, and I've got a 17-year-old daughter. And vitamins, yeah. Yeah. But the interesting thing about young girls as they grow up, around ages 12, 13, no matter what kind of job you've done, bringing up a gal is a time that they sort of start rejecting you. It's sort of the opposite side of Cats in the Cradle. And for fathers, this is, you know, especially a tough time, you know, daddy's little girl and all that stuff. And I'm sure most of the gals out there can remember back to around that time. Oh, you guys are doing that.
You guitar dad or something?
Oh, okay. We're screwing around up here. Don't mind us.
It's part of the show.
Just a little drama, whether it's going to work or not. The guys there, unless you're a father already, probably won't be able to relate to this as much, but in a few years maybe you will. If for the meantime, just sort of suck your thumb and, you know, we'll get there. If any of you have daughters yourself, gals out there too, mothers can relate, I think.
It's a song called Tangled Up Puppet, or A Song for Jamie. I'm a tangled up puppet spinning round in knots, and the more I see what used to be, the less of you I've got. There was a time that you curled up in my lap like a child. You clinged to me smiling, your eyes wide and wild. Now you slip through my arms, wave a passing hello, twist away and toss a kiss, laughing as you go. You used to say, read me a story and sing me songs of love. For you a princess paradise on the wings of a dove. Now I chase you and tease you, trying to remake you my own. But you just turn away and say, please leave me alone. And I'm a tangled up puppet, all hanging in your strings. I'm a butterfly in a spider's web, fluttering my wings. And the more that I keep dancing and spinning round in knots, the more I see what used to be, and the less of you I've got. You are a drawer full of makeup and rinses and things. You keep changing your moods like your earrings and rings. But tonight while we play tag for 5 minutes in the yard, well, just for a moment, I caught you off guard. And I'm a tangled up puppet, all hanging in your strings. I'm a butterfly in a spider's web, fluttering my wings. And the more that I keep dancing and spinning round in knots, the more I see what used to be, and the less of you I've got. Your secret pose in a room just for your dreams. You don't find time to talk to me about the things you mean. What I mean is, I have watched you take shape from a jumble of parts, and find the grace and form of a fine work of art. Hey, you, my brand new woman, newly come into your own. Don't you know that you don't need to grow up all Frisco. I needed one more fare to make my night a
lady up ahead waved the flag me down. She got in at the lights. Oh, where you going to, my lady blue? It's a shame you ruined your gown in the rain. She just looked out the window. She said 16 Parkside Lane. Something about her was familiar. I could swear I'd seen her face before. But she said, I'm sure you're mistaken. And she didn't say anything more. It took a while, but she looked in the mirror. Then she glanced at the license for my name. A smile seemed to come to her slowly. It was a sad smile, just the same. And she said, how are you, Harry? I said, how are you, Sue? Through the too many miles and the two little smiles, I still remember you. It was somewhere in a fairy tale. I used to take her home in my car. We learned about her love in the back of the Dodge. The lesson hadn't gone too far. You see, she was gonna be an actress, and I was gonna learn to fly. She took off to find the footlights. I took off to find the sky. Well, I've got something inside me to drive a princess blind. There's a wild man wizard, he's hiding in me, illuminating my mind. It's not what my life's about. Cause I've been letting my outside tide me over till my time runs out. There was not much more for us to talk about. Whatever we had once was gone. So I turned my cab to the driveway, past the gate and the fine trim lawns. And she said, we must get together, but I knew it'd never be arranged. Then she handed me $20 for a $2.50 fare. She said, Harry, keep the change. Well, another man might have been angry, and another man might have been hurt, but another man never would have let it go. I stashed the bill in my shirt. And she walked away in silence. It's strange how you never know. We'd both gotten what we'd asked for such a long, long time ago. You see, she was gonna be an actress, and I was gonna learn to fly. She took off to find the footlights, I took off for the sky. And here she's acting happy inside her handsome home. And me, I'm flying in my taxi, taking tips and getting stoned. I go flying so high when I'm stoned. Big John again.
Sounded like you both got what you were after in that song.
Well, John, sort of true, I guess. We're going to end the first half, have a little mercy on you folks, after this next song. Only if you promise that we, when we come back, you'll come back. We've had problems in the past. Steven, you remember when we, the old Chapin Brothers days, when we used to never take half times at concerts because we were, you know, worried. The amazing shrinking audience, you know. One of the things we do in the States after concerts, the guys and I are proud of the fact that we probably are more socially involved, I guess, than any band in the kind of, in the United States. We do more benefits, I guess. We did about 130 last year. And
boy, did we get tired.
But this year it looks like we'll be raising around $700,000 for things we believe in. And one of the ways we do this, besides benefits, is after concerts, you know, various groups sell various programs, T-shirts, things. And we do the same thing, except all the money goes to various things we believe in. And one of the things we work a lot on is hunger. The hunger situation really is truly obscene. We've got enough food to feed 8 billion people on this planet, and we've got 4 billion, and yet half a billion, I guess the most conservative estimates say 460 million humans go to bed chronically malnourished, which is the polite technical term for starving. And it really is pretty close to the basic definition of obscenity, I think. Our priorities are really screwed up. And one of the things I'm trying to do over here with either our organization or maybe Oxfam or something is to do one of the things we do in the States, which are hungerthons. We go into major radio markets, excuse me, and take over radio station for 24 hours and have what we call a hungerthon, where we have all the various groups and people working on this issue come on, talk about what they're doing, and meanwhile have various performers and artists call in or come stop by the studio, and it's sort of like a live radio show. It's the kind of thing they used to do in the old days. And the way we raise the money for this is by selling things like, after the show tonight or at halftime, there's a poetry book I recently finished I'm very proud of, and T-shirts that say Harry Chapin, World Hunger Year on them. And if you're willing to drop a couple of quid, is that the word? I'm willing after the show tonight to encourage you to be ripped off again. I would be delighted to be out there myself. It'll be a nice chance to meet everybody, people in the cheap seats. I can't see you up there, but I know you're there. And anybody who does buy anything, I'll sign anything you want on it. If you've got an enemy you want to send something to, I'll write something suitably obscene. If you've got a dear friend, I'll write something suitably intimate. And anyway, as I say, I've got no hot plans after the show tonight, so we might as well spend some time together. So if you want to hang around, that's where I'll be. There's a table out there in the lobby. So thank you very much. I don't know how many people here read Rolling Stone magazine, but about 2 months ago, there was an article on Robert De Niro. It was a cover story. And in that article was a quote that I was pleasantly surprised to read. It said that the movie Taxi Driver was inspired by two events. One was the Bremer Diaries. Arthur Bremer was the guy who shot George Wallace, about 1970, I believe. And the other one was Harry Chapin's Taxi. Now, the irony is that the Bremer Diaries inspired a song of mine also. And as a matter of fact, many people have said that the film Taxi Driver is really a combination of Taxi and the song I'm about to sing. It's called Sniper. I don't do it that much because it tears the goddamn hell out of my voice, but I'm, what the hell, I haven't got much left anyway, so we'll have some fun. And it's, you know, for about 15 years in the United States, we've been having seemingly people jump out of nowhere and etch themselves rather bloodily on our collective consciousness. You know, Speck, Starkweather, Manson, well, Bremer, and then Oswald, Sirhan, James Earl Ray, and our latest son of Sam, who gave New York something to worry about beyond all the other things for the last couple of years. And so it's a song that you might listen to. I think we're going to see more and more random violence in our collective societies until even if we at the center of society feel a certain lack of affect and effect on what's going on, you can imagine how the people in the fringes feel. And there's getting to be more and more people on the fringes. Sniper.
It is an early Monday morning. The sun is becoming bright on the land. No one is watching as he comes a-walking. Two bulky suitcases hang from his hands. He heads towards the tower that stands in the campus. Goes through the door, starts up the stairs. The sound of his footsteps, the sound of his breathing, the sound of the silence, but no one was there. I didn't really know him, he was kind of strange. He always sort of sat there, he never seemed to change. He reached the catwalk, he put down his burden. The four-sided clock began to chime. It's 7 a.m., the day is beginning. So much to do, so little time. He looked at the city where no one had known him. He looked at the sky where no one looks down. He looks at his life and what it had shown him. He looks for his shadow, it cannot be found. He was such a wounded child, very hard to touch. Even as a baby, he never smiled too much. No, no. No, no. You bought me, she said. You're ugly, she said. Please hug me, I said. But she just sat there with the same flat stare that she saves for me alone when I'm home. When I'm home, take me home. He laid out the rifles and loaded the shotgun, stacked up the cartridges along the wall. He knew he would need them for his conversation. If it went as he planned, then he might use them all. He said, listen, you people, you won't pay attention, but I'll ask anyhow. I found a way that will force you to answer. Been waiting to ask you till now. Right now. Am I am a lover who's never been kissed. Am I
Are you listening to me? Are you listening to me? Am I? The first words he spoke took the town by surprise. One got Mrs. Gibbons above her right eye. It blew her through the window, wedged her against the door. Reality poured from her face, staining the floor. He was kinda creepy, sort of a dunce. I met him at the corner bar, but only dated the poor boy once, that's all. Just once, that was all. Bill Whedon was questioned as he stepped from his car. Tom Scott ran across the street, but he never got that far. Police were there in minutes, they set up barricades, but he spoke right on over them in a half-mile circle. In a dumbstruck city, his pointed questions were sprayed. He knocked over Danny Tyson as he ran towards the noise. And just about then the answer started coming. Sweet, sweet joy. Thudding in the clock face, lighted off the walls. Reaching up to where he sat there answering calls. 37 people got his message so far. Yes, he was reaching them right where they are. They set up an assault team, they asked for volunteers. They had to go and get him, language was clear. And the word spread about him on the radios and TV. In appropriately sober tones they asked, who can he be? He was a very dull boy, a very taciturn. Not much of a joiner, he did not want to learn. On noon now, it's going to be soon now. But oh, what a wonderful soul. Mama, won't you nurse me? Rain me down the sweet milk of your kindness. Oh, mama, it's getting worse for me. Won't you please make me warm and mindless, mama? Yes, you have cursed me. I never will forgive you for your blindness. I hate you. The warriors are all humming for me, and I can hear them coming for me. Soon they'll be here, but there's nothing to fear. Not anymore. They blasted the door. As the copter dropped the gas, he shouted, who cares? They could hear him laughing as he started up the stairs. They stormed out on the catwalk, winking at the sun. With their final fusillade, his answer had come. Put your fire inside me. Am I?
See you in 15 minutes.
Sing near my God to thee.
Who?
The icebergs on the starboard bow.
Plug it in.
Won't you dance with me?
So like last year.
There's a kid out. Oh mama, where are you? There's a kid out on my corner. I hear him strumming like a fool, shivering in his dungarees, but still he's going to school. His cheeks are made of peach fuzz, his hopes may be the same, but he signed up as a soldier out to play the music game. There are fake patches on his jacket, he's used bleach to fade his jeans, with a brand new State Press shirt, some creased and wrinkled dreams. His face a blemished garden, but his eyes are virgin clear. His voice is Chicken Little's, but he's hearing Paul Revere. When he catches himself giggling, he forces up a sneer. Though he'd rather have a milkshake, he keeps forcing down the beers. He's just another folky laden coming down the pike, and he's riding his guitar. He left Kid Brother with his bike. And there's Guthrie running in his bones. He's the hobo kid who's left his home. His Beatles records and the Rolling Stones. This boy is staying acoustic. Now there's Seeger singing in his heart. He hopes his songs will somehow start to heal the cracks that split apart America gone plastic. And now there's Dylan dripping from his mouth, and he's hitching himself way down south to learn a little black and blues from old street men who paid their dues, cause they knew they had nothing to lose. They knew it, and so they just got to it, with cracked old Gibsons and red clay shoes, playing 1-4-5 chords like good news, and cursed with skin that calls for blood. They put their face and feet in mud, but oh, they learned the music from way down there. Yeah, the real ones learn it somewhere. Ah, strum your guitar, sing it, kid. Just write about your feelings, not the things you never did. Inexperience, it once accursed me, but your youth is no handicap, it's what makes you thirsty. Steps as you're kicking up the dust, and the rustling in the shadows tells you secrets you can trust. The capturing of whispers, there's a way to write a song. It's when you get to microphones, the music can go wrong. Only you are crying there behind the silver screen. Now you battle dragons, but they all turn into frogs. When you grab the wheel of fortune, you'll get caught up in the cogs. First your art turns into craft, then the yahoos start to laugh. Then you'll hear jackals howl, cause they love to watch the fall. They're the lost ones out there feeding on the wounded and the bleeding. Yeah, they always are the first to see the cracks upon the walls.
Well, I started a song, I was still 33. That's the age that Mozart died and sweet Jesus was set free. Keats and Shelley too soon finished, Charlie Parker would be. And I fantasized some tragedy'd be soon curtailing me.
Well, just today I had my birthday. I made it 34. I'm immortal, not immortal. I'm not star-crossed anymore. I got this problem with my aging I no longer can ignore. You see, a tame and toothless tabby can't produce a lion's roar. And you know I can't help feeling frightened on these midnight afternoons when I ask the loaded questions, why does winter come so soon? And where are all the golden girls that I've been singing for? The daybreak chorus of my dreams serenades no more. Yeah, the minute man is going soft, the mirror's on the shelf. Only when the truth's up there can you fool yourself. I am the aging jester who won't gracefully retire. A clumsy clown without a mitt, caught staggering on the high wire. Yesterday's a collar that is set around my waist. Today keeps slipping by me, but it leaves no aftertaste. Tomorrow is a daydream, is the future ever true? Am I just a fading fire or a breeze passing through? Hello, my country. Oh, I once came to tell everyone your story. Your passion was my poetry, and your past was my most potent glory. Your promise was my prayer, and your hypocrisy, my nightmare. Now your problems fill my prison. Oh, we're both going somewhere. Step all up, oh girl, your 200 birthdays make you old if not senile. And we see the symptoms there in your rigor mortis smile, with your old folks eating dog food and your children eating paint. And while the pirates own the flag and sell us sermons on restraint, and while blood's the only language that your deaf old ears can hear, and still you will not answer with that message coming clear. Does it mean there are no more ripples in your tide or glory stream, that the buzzards own the carcass of your dream? Up bicentennial, sell them pre-cannel after. America perennial, sing happy ever after. We're on the dance band on the Titanic, sing dear my God to thee. And there's the iceberg on the starboard bow, won't you dance with me? Well, I read it in the New York Times, it was on the stands today. It said the dreams are out of fashion, we hear no more empty promises. There'll be no more wasted passions to clutter up the play. And it really was a good sign, the words went on to say. It shows that we are growing up in oh so many healthy ways. And I told myself, yes, this is exactly where I'm at, but I don't much like thinking about that. When you hold a knife that carves it, and you live the life. for them. If you just dream when you're asleep, there is no way for them to come alive to survive. See, when the hurricane is coming on, it's not enough to flee. It's not enough to be alive, we hide behind that word. It's not enough to be alive when your future's been deferred. That I never will find out. Is music propaganda? Should I boogie rock and roll? Or is it the distant early warning system hitched up to our souls? Am I observer or participant, a huckster of belief, making too much of a life so mercifully brief? I stride down sunny streets, and the band plays back my song. They're applauding at my shadow long after I'm gone. Should I hold this wistful notion that the journey is worthwhile, to tiptoe across the chasm with a song and a smile? Well, I woke up this morning, I don't need to know no more, 'cause it evaporated nightmares that had boiled the night before. And with every new day's dawning, my kid climbs in my bed and shows the cynics of the boardroom that their language is dead. And as I wander with my music through the jungles of despair, my kid will learn guitar and find a street corner somewhere. There he'll make the silence listen to the dream behind the voice, and show his minstrel Hamlet daddy that there only was one choice. Oh, strum your guitar, sing it, kid. Write about your feelings, not the things you never did. Oh, inexperience, it once had cursed me. But your youth is no handicap, it's what makes you thirsty. Hey, kid. Oh, strum your guitar, sing it, kid. Just write about your feelings, not the things you never did. There's a dance band on the Titanic, sing near my God to thee. The iceberg's on the starboard bow, won't you dance with me? There's a dance band on the Titanic, sing near my God to thee. The iceberg's on the starboard bow, won't you dance with me? Come on now. There's a dance band on the Titanic, sing near my God to thee. And the iceberg's on the starboard bow, won't you dance with me? There's a dance band on the Titanic, sing near my God to thee. The iceberg's on the starboard bow, won't you dance with me? Thank you.
All right. A one, a two, a one, two, three, four. My child arrived just the other day. He came to the world in the usual way, but there were planes to catch and bills to pay. He learned to walk while I was away, and he was talking for I knew it. And as he grew, he'd say, I'm gonna be like you, Dad. You know I'm gonna be like you. And the cat's in the cradle and a silver spoon, little boy blue and the man on the moon. When you're coming home, Dad, I don't know when, but we'll get together then, son. You know we'll have a good time then. When my son turned 10 just the other day, he said, thanks for the ball, Dad, come on, let's play. Can you teach me to throw? I said, not today, I got a lot to do. He said, that's okay, and he walked away, but his smile never dimmed. He said, I'm gonna be like him, yeah, you know I'm gonna be like him. And the cat's in the cradle and a silver spoon, little boy blue and the man on the moon. When you're coming home, Dad, I don't know when, but we'll get together then, son. You know we'll have a good time then. Well, he came from college just the other day, so much like a man, I just had to say, son, I'm proud of you, can you sit for a while? He shook his head and he said with a smile, what I'd really like, Dad, is to borrow the car keys. See you later, can I have them, please? And the cat's in the cradle and a silver spoon, little boy blue and the man on the moon. When you're coming home, son, I don't know when, we'll get together then, Dad. You know we'll have a good time then. Well, I've long since retired, my son's moved away. Called him up just the other day. I said, I'd like to see you if you don't mind. He said, I'd love to, Dad, if I can find the time. You see, my new job's a hassle and the kids have the flu, but it's sure nice talking to you, Dad. It's been sure nice talking to you. And as he hung up the phone, it occurred to me, he'd grown up just like me. My boy was just like me. And the cat's in the cradle and a silver spoon, little boy blue and the man on the moon. When you're coming home, son, I don't know when, but we'll get together then, and you know we'll have a good time then.
Now, when we were in April, we tried out a new song that was about an old black blind blues street preacher and guitar picker. And a young white boy was trying to go learn some of the old man's licks. And on a new album, which is, as you've gathered by now, called Dance Band on the Titanic, there are many themes that are interwoven from song to song, coming back and forth. And this is a story about such an old black blind blues street preacher, who is played by Big John, and such a young white boy from up north, say some big city in New York, Philadelphia, Baltimore, Washington, played by Dougie Walker over here. And then the various other subsidiary roles. So see if you can pick everybody out. I'm the narrator. You folks can be the Greek chorus. Women robed in black, who moaned and groaned and commented on the action. So if you'd like to moan, now comment on the action at any point you'd like to. And here's a story about the old blues man. Well, the kid heard the word up in Brooklyn. It was the second year of medical school. He went and stashed some jeans into his guitar case. His father said,
"Yo, Mabel, that kid of yours is a fool."
Well, he jumped on board that Greyhound bus. It took him 2 days to get to Mobile. And though it took 2 more weeks to track the old man down, he never doubted that the rumor was real. And that old man stood by the storefront. He had a white cane hanging from his belt, and he was bending the steel of his guitar strings, so it seemed like the metal had to melt. He was the last of the street corner singers in his final years of blues. The buzz in his throat was like a bullfrog croak. Yes, it's he who invented the blues.
Blues, boy, now you got to live 'em, goddamn blues, boy. You know you got to give 'em, got to start sweet like a slow blues rhythm, like a heartbeat. Now you'll always be with 'em when you're married to the blues. Your guitar is your wife. It's like that final.
All right, Big John. Well, the kid walks up as the blind man finished and was bent to put his guitar away. You know, the old man heard him and said, "Who are you?"
"Well, I'm the kid you're gonna teach to play, Dad."
That old man laughed, but the kid kept talking about how he'd help him get on around. That's when the old man said,
"Well, I don't need no food. Get the way out of the hell I'm bound."
Now I must admit that made the young boy pause for just a moment, but then he nods his head with a great big grin and says,
"Oh, when do we begin?"
That's when the old man says,
"If you stay with me, this is how it's got to be.
Tell 'em to play the blues, boy. You got to live and got to do, boy. You know you got to give and got to start sweet like a smoke blues rhythm, like a heartbeat. You'll always be with them when you're married to the blues, boy. Your guitar is your wife. It's like that fine old woman who you're faithful to for life."
Like a woman, slow and easy.
Like this old man?
No, no, no. Who plays the blues like Machine Gun Kelly? 500 notes to the bar. If you wanna stay with me, you got to learn what the blues really are. Come on, kid, let's get going. It's time to blow this town. With your mouth.
You're the blues, boy. You got to live and got to do's, boy. You know you got to give and got to start sweet like slow blues rhythm, like a heartbeat. You'll always be with them when you're married to the blues, boy. The guitar is your wife. All right. 3.5 years ago, I wrote a country and western song, my first, and it was somewhat of a success. It got to be the number one request song in Des Moines, Iowa for 5 weeks in a row in 1975. And fresh from that triumph, you would have thought that I had would write, you know, reams of country and western material. I didn't. But about 6 months ago, soon before I came here in April, I wrote my second country and western song. And we sang it that night, and we've sung it a couple times since, and it feels pretty good. So if you'd like to listen, it's sort of halfway between a Woody Guthrie talking blues and a Charlie Daniels song. It's also about cross-class pollination. Now, if you wonder what the hell that is, just listen to the song, and it shall unfold, and hopefully the payoff is worth the story. Are you ready, Kim? Can you make that pregnant violin of yours sound like a country fiddle?
I give part-time help. I'm the odd job man. I can't do what I want, so I do what I can. And I'll tell you now so that you will understand. You get just what you pay for from the odd job man. This dude drives in the station, and I slide out to the pump. And he says, I need some odd jobs done. Can you get off from this dump? Well, I can always use some extra bread, so I nod and take the job. When he says, clean up before you come, I do not hire slobs. Now you can see I'm not no fancy pants, but everyone has pride, and especially since this lovely lady's sitting by his side. Still, something keeps my trap shut, and I nod again, all right. And he gooses his Mercedes, and he squeals off in the night. Well, I give part-time help. I'm the odd job man. Can't do what I want, so I do what I can. And I'll tell you now, so that you will understand. Get just what you pay for from the odd job man. When I find this place next morning, it's more a palace than a pad. And it kind of makes my pickup truck start looking pretty bad. But the same lady swings the door back, and before one word is said, she leads me to his trophy room where he sits with his stuffed heads. He's got this list of jobs for me to do while he's out of town. And he says, I'm too damn busy, boy, the way I move around. So I start to figure prices when he says, it's time you learn. When you're dealing with a gentleman, you get just what you earn. I give part-time help. I'm the odd job man. Can't do what I want, so I do what I can. And I'll tell you now, so that you will understand. You get just what you pay for from the odd job man. So I set to work that weekend, and I'm fixing up some stairs, when I feel that someone's watching me, and I see she's standing there. She says, I like to watch you work, you have such supple hands. She says, can I help you? And I say, maybe you can. Well, she looks me in the eyes, boys, and I admit I looked a little lower. That's when she starts breathing faster, and I start working slower. You see, when you have a helper with her attitude and grace, you start putting lots of extra hours working around the place. Part-time help, I I'm the odd job man, and I can't do what I want, so I do what I can. Well, a month or two soon come and gone, with my odd jobs all done, and who should pull up to the pump but the long-lost prodigal son? And he says, here's $100, boy, and he pulls the bill off from his wad, and he starts to hand it over like a gift comes straight from God. I say, that's just $1 an hour, sir. He says, that's what I pay for jerks. Now, I admit that almost blew my cool, but I staggered back to work. You see, most times when it's said and done, there's justice to this life, 'cause what that man had done to me, I'd done to his wife. Oh, I get part-time help, I'm the odd job man. Can't do what I want, so I do what I can. And I'll tell you now, so that you will understand, you get just what you pay for from the odd job man.
I guess this year is your silver jubilee year, and last year was our bicentennial. And with my usual impeccable sense of timing, I've finally put together my bicentennial medley. And they're both historical songs. One's about, well, like 200, 210 years ago, and the second one's about 100 years ago. I like to sort of do them back to back. It's... I'll set the mood. It's 1767, and we're at about a 4 or 5 hours ride north of Boston, Massachusetts, on the east coast of the United States. And we're standing on a cliff. It's 3 a.m., and we're looking down below where the waves are crashing on the granite rocks. Weird glows of phosphorescence occasionally appear. And we're looking up above also, and there's a full moon. It's one of those wild nights where intermittently rain clouds go across the face of the moon and you feel drops on your face. And just as you're thinking, God, what a wild, lonely, desolate spot, when you hear behind you a clatter of a shutter, you turn around, and there about 50 yards inland is the hulking bulk of an old farmhouse. And indeed, on the second story, there seems to be a dark shape moving back and forth, and you remember about widow's walks. And as you watch, the shape goes back inside, you hear the shutters close again, and you walk over with a certain amount of trepidation to the windows in the first floor and press your nose against the thick blown glass of the window panes. And there, slightly distorted, is a dying fire in the fireplace. The last glowing embers are reflected by two shining shapes over in the corner of the room, and another glowing dark shape. And as a woman comes downstairs, and indeed it is a woman, she goes over to the rocking chair in front of the fireplace and starts creaking back and forth. And that's when you hear the story of Dogtown.
Massachusetts, there's a little spit of land. The men who make the maps has to call the place Cape Ann. The men who do the fishing call it Cluster Harbor Sound. But the women left behind, yes, they call the place Dogtown. The men go out for whaling, past the breakers and the fogs, while the women stay home waiting. They're protected by the dogs, and a tough old whaler woman who had seen three husbands drown. She polled the population and she named the place Dogtown. There's always gray-faced women in their black widow's gowns living in this graveyard, Granite Town. Yeah, you soon learn there's many, more than one way to drown. That's why I'm going to the docks here in Dogtown. Listen as she speaks. My father, he was a merchant, all in the Boston Fife. When my husband came and asked him for my hand, but a little did I know then that a Gloucester whaler's wife marries but the sea salt and the sand. He took me up to Dogtown the day I was a bride, and we had 10 days together before he left my side. He's the first mate of a whaling ship, yes, the keeper of the log, and he said, farewell, my darling, I'm going to leave you with my dog. And I have seen the splintered timbers of 100 shattered hulls, known the silence of granite and the screeching of ghosts. I've heard that crazy widow Calla walk the harbor as she raves at the endless rolling whisper of the waves. I'm sitting by the fireside, the embers slowly die. Is it a sign of weakness when a woman wants to cry? The dog is closely watching, the fire glints in his eye. No use to go to sleep this early, no use to even try. Like a woman's, I've got a woman's breasts and thighs. But where am I to offer them? To the ocean or the skies? Living with a silent dog, all the moments of my life, he's been my only husband and my widow, well, his wife. Well, it's a dog town, and it's a bog town, and there's nothing around except our sea pounding granite ground and this black midnight horror of a hound. I'm standing on this craggy cliff, my eyes fixed on the sea. 6 months passed when his ship was due. I'm a widow to be. bastard of the mating of a woman and the dog. And I have seen the splintered timbers of 100 shattered hulls, known the silence of the granite and the screeching of the gulls. I've heard that crazy. Of the waves at the endless rolling whisper all the
It's 100 years later, and a young man our age is standing by a railroad depot in Great Plains States, and it is flat, flat, flat. And he's looking eastward at the horizon where there's a thin column of smoke going straight up in the motionless August air. And at the bottom of that column is a tiny little train that is gradually growing larger. And on that train is only one single passenger. Mail order Annie, come to find her husband. First, I did not think it could be you, but you're the only one that got off the train. See, you must be my wife, Miss Annie Halsey. Yes, yes, I guess I am your husband. Hello, I'm Harry Crane. Mail order Annie, never mind your crying. Your tears are sweet rain in my empty life. Mail order Annie, can't you see I'm trying to tell you that I'm glad you're here. You who are the woman who's come to be my wife. You know you're not as pretty as I dreamed you'd be, but then I'm not no handsome fancy Dan. And out here looks really not important. No, no, it's what's inside a woman when she's up against the land. Mail order Annie, never mind your crying. Your tears are sweet rain in my ear. You see, I'm trying to tell you that I'm glad you're here. You are the woman who's come to be my wife.
it's not no easy life you're entering. The winter wind comes whistling through the cracks there in the sod. You know you'll never have too many neighbors. There's you, girl, and there's me, and there's cars. You know I'm just a dirt man from the North Dakota plains. You're one girl from the city who's been thrown out on her own. And I'm standing here, not sure of what to say to you, except in mail order, Annie, let's you and me go home. Mail order, Annie, never mind, you're crying. Your tears are sweet rain in my empty life. Mail order, Annie, can't you see I'm trying to tell you that I'm glad you're here. You who are the woman who's come to be my wife.
With all the technical problems tonight, I think I should give myself a respite and also a treat. And the treat is the fact that it's my brother Steve, besides being our producer, is an incredible songwriter. For those of you who were in April, you heard a song of his. Would I like to get him to do it again? Steve, would you do Let Time Go Lightly? I'm going to go out in the audience and join us.
That leaves the evening.
share a fire with a friend or two, to lose sight of the hours, to go lightly with you. I let time go lightly when I'm here with you. I let time go lightly when the day is through. I keep watch on time and I've got work to do. But I let time go lightly with you. Much more to me than a new friend, 'cause they can see where you are and they know where you've been. Can make me so low. When I was a child, my mother would help me along. She'd rock me to sleep and sing me a song. So I learned to love the music of all the tunes in my mind, the changing of chords, the rhythm of time. I let time go lightly when I'm here with you. Yes, I let time go lightly with you, and a fire and a friend or two. With you and a fire and a friend or two. A friend or two, and you.
Thank you very much.
Steve Chapin. Whoa! Hey. Sounds good.
Hey.
Song.
Who's that large voice out there? Thank you very much.
Hey, Steve, I like it out here. I think I'll just sort of sit here for a while. There's a gal out right behind you who sang that song fantastically.
Yeah?
She knows every word. Would you like to go on tour with us? We're in Manchester tomorrow night, okay? The next night we're in Dublin, and then we're in Belfast, where we don't want to bomb because they got a different meaning for the word up there. But it's not bad. Nice lights. Kim, God, you look beautiful with orange light on your hair. You really do. Excuse
hey, buddy. Me I'm fall hey, buddy, did you, get, did you pay to get in here or what? Let me see your ticket.
I would like to wake everybody up here after all that beautiful music and lower the level definitively. And what I'm going to do it with is a song that I wrote for Johnny Cash to sing. He was too damn busy with his Amoco gas.
Well, I hear you playing that guitar, son. I know you're doing a song. Well, if I knew what the hell you were doing, I just might sing along. But I don't know what the hell you're doing.
Now, once again, the London Memorial Country Choir is in session. A one, a two, a one, two, three, boom. Now you gotta help us out. Would you give me a little guitar and the monitors, sort of make everybody know what's going on here?
Well, it was just after dark when the truck started down the hill that leads into Scranton, Pennsylvania, carrying 30,000 pounds of bananas. Yes, there were 30,000 pounds. Hit it, Big John.
Oh, bananas.
He was a young driver, just out on his second job, and he was carrying the next day's pasty fruit for everyone in that cold Wisconsin. The children play without despair in backyard slack piles, and folks manage to eat each day just about 30,000 pounds of bananas. Yes, there were 30,000 pounds. Ring it again, Big Joe. Now from here on out, you got the choruses, okay? He passed the saying that he should have seen, saying shift to low gear, a $50 laugh and my friend. He was thinking perhaps about the warm breath woman who was waiting at that journey's end. Started down the 2 mile drop, the curving road that wound from the top of the hill. He was pushing on through the shortening miles, wound down to the depot, just a few more miles to go. Then he'd go home and have a ease, that long cramp their way in the smell of 30,000 pounds. Do it to me. Yes, there were 30,000 pounds. Now don't so loud. All right, give me a little balls. I know it next time. Now this is where the song picks up in momentum and excitement. Picking up speed as the city spread, and twinkling lights below him. Paid no heed as the shivering thoughts of the night's delights went through him. His foot as the bricks to slow him down, but the pedal thought he'd see without a sound. He said, Christ! It was funny how he blamed the only man who could save him now. He was trapped inside a dirty hillside, riding on his spear hunchback. He's every one of those yellow green. I'm telling you, 30,000 pounds. Yes, there were 30,000 pounds. Louder! When it man made the sweeping curve that led into the steepest grade, and he missed the thankful passing bus at 90 miles an hour. And he said, God, make it a dream. As he rolled his last lap down, he said, God, make it a dream. As he rolled his last lap down. And he sat right 19 need park cars, clipped off 13 telephone poles, hit 2 houses, pushed 8 trees, blew 4 7 people. Then he lost his head, never mentioned an arm or two before he stopped. And he smeared for 400 yards along the hill that leads into Scranton, Pennsylvania. All those 30,000 pounds. You guessed it, cheap seats. They don't call them cheap seats for nothing. Now, come on. 30,000 pounds. Now really ream it good for me. Much better. Now, it's really funny. When I wrote this song to begin with, I thought it was a piece of weird black humor. And I had an idea just to end it with a certain simplicity. And then one crazy night in Champaign, Urbana, Illinois.
You gotta be kidding.
I had a crazy urge to explain to people how I had trouble ending the song. And something strange happened. The song kept getting longer
and longer, and indeed it has become something that we can't get away with not doing.
One night, so, we didn't even finish it. Everybody went home.
Sounds like bureaucracy, you know? Just keeps on growing and growing.
An amoeba, actually. But anyway, I'm going to go through at least the ending of the three times I tried to end 30,000 pounds of bananas. Now, the first one I thought was unbelievably clever of me. And if you know it, please help me out. Maybe finally we can persuade the guys that they would like to end it here after all these years.
Oh, yes, I'd love to.
I'm ready to end it right now.
It went like this. Help us out. Yes, we have no bananas. We have no bananas today. Come on, everybody, one more time. Oh, yes. We have no bananas. A little switch here. Bananas in Scranton, PA. Now, is that you, Ma?
Well, that guy can go home.
Yeah. Well, I sang that ending with a tremendous amount of excitement. And as some of you know, the reaction was slightly more succinct than I had hoped. They said, Harry!
Amazing how the word spreads.
Across that large ocean.
Well, I was devastated because, as some of you still may know, that is not just an obscenity, and indeed we're trying to do a family show tonight, but that's a technical term used in the American musical business, usually in reference to the Osmonds. And I was devastated, so I decided hurriedly to write another ending. Discretion is the greater part of valor. And I thought I'd write a country and western ending replete with weeping steel guitars and wailing fiddles. Good old barrel roll piano. Once again, we were going to deliver a real shit kicker. But the thing that's going to save it tonight, of all nights, is your incredible London Country Choir Harmony. Okay? The London Memorial Choir is in session. Okay? So you'll see your part as it comes by. Do it good. Maybe we can end the song here. Okay?
Get those parts.
A woman walks into a room where her child lies sleeping. Oh, I love it.
Hold on to those parts.
Yes. And when she sees her eyes are closed, she sits there silently weeping. Oh, 2,500 munchkins out there. And though she lives in Scranton, Pennsylvania,
radio,
she never, ever eats. Now do it for me, cheap seats. Oh, they're waking up there. Not a one of 30,000 pounds. Now what harmony? Remember this. A lot of harmony on this. Oh, banana. Whoa, whoa. Okay, we're going to have to assign them parts again. Okay, split it down the middle. The men on this side. Men. Oh, bananas.
All right, yeah.
The man on this side, oh, bananas. All right. Getting better each time. Let's see. The women on this side, oh, bananas. Oh, bananas. No, either one. Renee Richards, whatever you can work out. Oh, bananas. Why is it always the women lack balls on these numbers? Come on. Come on. Aren't women taking over in Britain, too? We men have been screwing it up long enough. Come on, it's your turn. Oh, bananas! There's one girl there. So, and somebody back there. Okay. The women on this side, see me do better. Oh, bananas!
Hey, girls. That was really fucking average.
Listen, there may be some of you who don't fit either category, and so I've got a part for you too. Oh, bananas! Maybe not. I thought London was liberated too. Okay. Are you ready? Everybody's got their parts, okay? Oh, bananas, 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 bananas.
Yes, there were 30,000 pounds.
Hyperventilate, giant breath.
Oh, banana.
Not bad. Now, the problem is, no matter how well you sing of bananas, and you did pretty fair, it doesn't alter the memory I have of singing that to the guys in the group and having them say in perfect unison, Harry! It's amazing how you do that really well, you know? God damn.
Listen, Harry, instead of torturing yourself about old endings that we dumped on, you know, why don't you go to that old writer's garret in the sky? Go on. Assault the bulwarks one more time.
So I did.
Back into the breach, as it were.
So I did. And there I was, remembering how I came through Scranton, Pennsylvania, in 1965 on that Greyhound bus.
A little old man.
And how the elderly gentleman got in without any teeth, sat down beside me, and he gummed me the story like this. You see, the man who told me about it on the bus as it went up the hill out of Scranton, Pennsylvania, shrugged his shoulders, shook his head, and he said, and this is exactly what he said as closely as I can reproduce it for you now. He said, and I quote,
"Boy, it sure must have been something. Just imagine 30,000 pounds of bananas. Yes, there were 30,000 pounds of mashed banana. A banana, a banana. Sing it with me louder.
Well, all right. The moment has arrived. It is 1912. We are in the British Isles, of course. And it is April the 12th. And the triumph of technology. The first time man has conquered nature. The unsinkable vessel is about to set sail upon its maiden voyage. And you are there.
Sink this ship. Well, the whistle blew and they turned the screws. It churned the water into foam. Our destination, sweet salvation. Goodbye, home, sweet home. We're in the dance band of the Titanic, singing my God to thee. The
Masters on the starboard bow. Won't you dance with me? We had a trombone and a saxophone. The bass and drums were cooking on a bandstand. And I was strumming in the middle with this dude on the fiddle. We were 3 days out from land. And now the foghorn's jammed and moaning. I heard it droning through the mist at night. I heard a lookout shout down as icebergs around. But everything's still alright. We're in the dance band on the Titanic. Singing my God to thee. The icebergs on the starboard bow. Won't you dance with me? Yeah, the burning of the flowers for candles. In a banquet that they're throwing in first class. And here we're blowing waltzes in a ballroom. When the universe went crazy. That's what I heard the chaplain say. Women and children and chaplains first. Lord. Well, they soon used up all of the lifeboats, but there were a lot of us still left on board. That's when I heard the drummer saying, boys, just keep playing. Now we're doing his deed for the Lord. In the dance band on the Titanic, singing my God to thee. The icebergs on the starboard bow, won't you dance with me? There's a wild-eyed boy in a radio shack. He's the last remaining guest. I hear him tapping in a most old friend of mama. He's tapping, please, God, S.O.S. Jesus Christ could walk on the water where a music man will drown. And Nero may have fiddled while the man up, but I was jumping as the ship go now out. We're in the dance band on the Titanic, singing my God to thee. The icebergs on the starboard bow, won't you dance with me? We're in the dance band on the Titanic, singing my God to thee. And the icebergs on the starboard bow, won't you dance with me? The starboard bow, won't you dance with me?
I think I've broken about 17 guitar strings tonight. I should have played six-string orchestra, except it would have been five or four-string. I've had a fantastic time. I want to thank you for being the kind of audience that sort of lets things glide out, even though we're falling apart up here technically. And hope to be back again soon. We've got a nice, I guess, 9 days set up, traveling all around to various parts of the British Isles. We've been over here for about 8 days, and We had some wild experiences after leaving here in last April, and I'll tell you about maybe next time. But I'd like to sing sort of our Chapin theme song. It goes like this. All my life's a circle, sunrise and sundown. Moon rolls through the nighttime till the daybreak comes around. Oh, all my life's a circle, but I can't tell you why. The season's spinning round again, the years keep rolling by. Well, it seems like I've been here before. I can't remember when. Got this funny feeling that we'll all get together again. There are no straight lines make up my life, and all my ropes have bends. No clear-cut beginnings, and so far no dead end. You got it, Steve. Sing it good now.
Well, I found you a thousand times. Guess you've done same. But then we lose each other. It's just like a children's game. But as I find you here again, the thought runs through my mind. Our love is like a roundabout. Let's go round one more time.
All right, now let's help me out, okay? All my life's a circle. Sunrise and sundown. The moon rolls through the nighttime till the daybreak comes around. All my life's a circle. I can't tell you, I can't tell you why. The season's spinning round again. The years keep rolling by. You know, I'm gonna find that girl over here who's singing so good. Come on, you can sing it. You can help her out, okay? Both of you. Can you do a duet? Okay, you, Sonny and Cher. You'll both do it together, okay? Here you go. Everybody's got to give him a giant countdown to get him excited, okay? It goes like this. One, two, three, four. But you can't just count quiet. Really loud, okay? You know, last time. Here we go.
All my life's a circle. Sunrise and sundown. The moon rose through the nighttime till the daybreak comes around. All my life's a circle, but I can't tell you why. The season's spinning round again, the years keep rolling by.
Hey guys, I think it's time I was retired, put out to pasture. You got a new lead singer, okay? You write songs too? He does. It's all over. Are they story songs or just story songs, as girl says? Are they stories about you? I mean, you only had one story in your life. God almighty. Okay, is everybody else ready now? Inspired? Okay, I want you to stand up and get them to sing, okay? Just stand up here and just sort of give them a little conducting like this, okay? One, two, one, two, three, four.
Sunrise and sun.
Moon rolls through the nighttime.
The moon rolls through the nighttime.
Till the daybreak comes.
Daybreak comes around.
All my life's a circle.
All my life's a circle.
But I can't tell you why.
I can't tell you why.
Season's spinning round again.
Season's spinning round.
Years keep rolling.
Years keep rolling by.
As always, there's a couple of tragically hip people here, you know, shirts open to the navel, and they're sort of sitting there. Don't give him anything tonight, okay? Please. All right. Kim, are you ready to be the final orgasmic finish of this? Come on, stand up there and sing. Come on.
Tell you why. Season's spinning round again. Years keep rolling. I tell you what, you guys stand up, turn 180 degrees, and sing it for them and show them how it should be done, okay? You ready? Come on, just do it. You're gonna have to walk out anyway, right? It's the end of the show. Stand up, turn 180 degrees. Here we go. Now give them a countdown. See if you get them excited. Here we go. One, two. Sun rising, moon rolls through, till the daybreak comes. All my life's a circle. I can't tell you why. Seasons spin around again. Years keep rolling. Okay, everybody, place the glory. Put your hands together. A circle, sunrise, and sundown. The moon rolls through, and the moon rolls through the nighttime. Till the daybreak, and the daybreak comes around. All my life's a circle. I can't tell you why. The season's spinning round again. The years keep rolling. About 2 minutes. Great night. Kim Scholes, Doug Walker, Big John Wallace, Howie Fields, Steve Chapin.